So, this is not a usual 3D printing unboxing video where everything works out just fine. It's about what can happen in the real world and what you can do about it. I think it's for beginners that just want to print something. It's also for photographers and why they maybe need a 3D printer. So let's start. I chose to get an Artillery Sidewinder X2 printer because I was pretty happy with my Sidewinder X1. And have a lot of spare parts for the X1 that also fits on the X2. The Sidewinder X2 supports AutoBed mesh leveling and has already some improvements. The rest of the improvements for your printer you can find on Thingiverse and print by yourself. You can find a link to the website in the description. You can also find affiliate links to all used tools down there and can support the channel with using them. I also like that the heating for the building plate heats up super fast. The printer has a huge area for your prints. It's 30x30x40 cm, and most importantly, it's very, very silent. It's a great printer for the price. But if you want to go for a system that just works from the beginning perfectly, maybe you want to have a look at the Prusa printers or other more expensive options. After unboxing, I got my iPad with the latest manual. I think it's always good to download the latest manual because sometimes the one in the package can be older and you're missing some things. After you got your printer out of the box, you only need to put these two parts together and assemble the filament holder. And then you can start. Sadly, this was not my case again. Remember the last two videos? Anyways, the building plate locked into some places. I tried to loosen the eccentric screws, but it did not help. So I took off all wheels and found out that every single one of them has scratches and dents. Luckily, I had enough replacement wheels at home and replaced them. It's always a good idea to have enough spare parts for your printer at home, and you will also need a lot of different tools if you start with 3D printing. So that's how my spare parts and tools arsenal looks like. So back to the wheels. So I called the company who sold me the printer, it's 3djake.at, and they were very helpful and agreed to send me new wheels. You know, they have offered and could have got me a new printer as well, but it was lockdown and I did not want to repackage everything and send it back. After I assembled everything again, I figured that the next axis had the same issue. So I replaced the wheels there too. And then listen to the sound. Also the Z axis had the same issue. So I got lots more replacement wheels from 3djake. Thanks a lot for you guys. Your support was really great. I will link the company down in the description. Before I start to work with the printer, I replaced the nozzle with a better one because it is very easy to do so before you start with your first print. After everything finally worked out, I started to manually level the building plate and did a mesh bed leveling afterwards. Now I was ready to go for my first print. I installed a HomeKit camera and a power plug, so I can check remotely if the printer is up and running, and if something funny happens, I can also turn it off remotely. Remember, a 3D printer gets very hot and can start to burn things if it gets messy. Don't leave it alone, or at least find a way to observe it. And you know, big prints can take up a very long time. We're talking here from several hours to a day. To build new parts, I used the Morphe app. It is very easy to use and available for macOS and iPadOS. And besides it's easy to use, it's also only a one-time payment, so you don't have to pay monthly for it. I really like that. And the support from the Morphe app guys is great if you write them. I really strongly can recommend them. After I finished my parts designing in Morphe, I sliced my parts in IdeaMaker. This software is not very common, but for my taste, it is very easy to use and I like the design of the software. As an analog or digital photographer, there is a lot of stuff out there that is waiting for you to print. Again, have a look at the Thingiverse page and just search for your camera with your strobe or your tripod brand. And you will be surprised what you find. Here's a wet blade holder, for example, or a wet blade drying rack. And not some parts I printed myself. This is an adapter for a Godox strobe, it's the AD200 Pro. I printed this with a TPU, it's a flexible material. This is an adapter to fit my Linhof board to my Century camera. And this is an adapter to fit the Century lens board on my 13x18cm Mentor camera. Here are some waterhouse stops I design and print. Just in case you need one, just contact me. And this is a flexible lens cap for a Yashica 124 mat of my girlfriend. I think it fits perfectly to this camera. If you follow me, you know that I use a lot of 3D printed parts for my work. It just makes life easier. Or sometimes it's just cool, like the little fins I printed. For functional parts, I can recommend the XPTG filament from Extruder. They have also lots of other great filament on their website. I will link everything for you guys down in the description as mentioned before. So everything else, there are a lot of videos out there where people talk about 3D printing that know much more than me. So if you need any special advices, maybe have a look at other videos. I just wanted to give you guys a little overview. And I hope you have a better idea now what 3D printing is about. It's not all roses what you see all the time, but after you figured it out, it's really cool to have a machine at home that can create great replacement parts for your cameras or anything else in your home, like for your keyboard, or there's so much stuff out there. So that's all for today, and as always guys, I'll be back.